Thanksgiving to Jesus and Mother Mary for favors received. Thanksgiving to Our Lady of Mount Carmel for blessings and favors received. Birthday blessings for Anthony Dias, good health and well-being of Fonseca family, souls of Godfrey and Lorna Steen, Natty Francis De Silva, Stephen and Apolline Fernandez, Valerian Fernandez, Karen Abreu, Grace Matthews, Nicholson Matthews, Acacio Fernandez, Jasmine and Anthony Fernandez, Rowena Pereira, Pinto Lobo and Suarez families, Harris and Bella Gomes, deceased members of Polilio Fernandez and Cynthia Fernandez families, Simon Barbosa, Pinto and Dias families, Mickey and Ozzy D'Souza, Gilbert and Shirley Barrow, Miguel and Mrs. Maria Brito family. We also pray for all your intentions. All together, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the priceless communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Jesus is our healer. And at this Eucharist, we ask the Lord and say, Jesus, heal us of all our infirmities. To celebrate the sacred mysteries of this Eucharist in a worthy manner, let us call to mind our sins and ask God's pardon and forgive us. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the Apocalypse. This is the revelation given by God to Jesus Christ, so that he could tell his servants about the things which are now to take place very soon. He sent his angel to make it known to his servant John, and John has written down everything he saw and swears it is the word of God, guaranteed by Jesus Christ. Happy the man who reads this prophecy, and happy those who listen to him if they treasure all that it says, because the time is close. From John to the seven churches of Asia, grace and peace to you, from him who is, who was and who is to come, from the seven spirits in his presence before his throne. I heard the Lord saying to me, write to the angel of the church of Ephesus and say, here is the message of the one who holds the seven stars in his right hand and who lives surrounded by the seven golden lampstands. I know all about you, how hard you work and how much you put up with. I know you cannot stand wicked men and how you tested the impostors who called themselves apostles and proved they were liars. I know too that you have patience and have suffered for my name without growing tired. Nevertheless, I have this complaint to make. You have less love now than you used to. Think where you were before you fell. Repent and do as you used to at first. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The words of our response are, those who prove victorious, I will feed from the tree of life. Kindly listen to the tune.
Those who prove victorious, I will feed from the tree of life. Those who prove victorious, I will feed from the tree of life.
Happy indeed is the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor lingers in the way of sinners, nor sits in the company of scholars, but whose delight is the law of the Lord, and who ponders his law day and night. Together.
Those who prove victorious, I will feed from the tree of life.
He is like a tree that is planted beside the flowing waters, that yields its fruit in due season, and whose leaves shall never fade, and all that he does shall prosper. Together.
Those who prove victorious, I will feed from the tree of life. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Anyone who follows me will have the light of life.
Alleluia, alleluia.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus drew near to Jericho, there was a blind man sitting at the side of the road begging. When he heard the crowd going past, he asked what it was all about, and they told him that Jesus the Nazarene was passing by. So he called out, Jesus, son of David, have pity on me. The people in front scolded him and told him to keep quiet, but he shouted all the louder, Son of David, have mercy on me. Jesus stopped and ordered them to bring the man to him, and when he came up, asked him, what do you want me to do for you? Sir, he replied, let me see again. Jesus said to him, receive your sight, your faith has saved you. And instantly his sight returned, and he followed him praising God, and all the people who saw it gave praise to God for what had happened. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
Imagine, my dear friends, if you had been blindfolded, say for at least 5 minutes, actually blindfolded, and you see nothing but only darkness. And if you have been asked to go around your house or go around anywhere in that darkness, how would you feel? In those 5 minutes, how would you feel? Absence of light makes our life absolutely miserable and extremely painful. With this little experience, we can try to understand how people who are partially visually impaired or totally blind, what their life is and how do they go about. The gospel passage tells us that Jesus is on his way to Jerusalem to celebrate the feast of the Passover. And when he reaches Jericho, he sees large crowds, pilgrims, and there are beggars. A blind beggar who had heard about Jesus believes in Jesus, trusts in Jesus, that this is the man, the answer, the solution to all my woes, and especially for his blindness. He calls out to Jesus in faith and says, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." In that desperate cry, in that cry of prayer, this man, we find there is a trusting faith, a believing faith, a faith in the healing power of Jesus, a faith in the mercy of Jesus. In this cry, my dear friends, he makes a prayer of conviction, a prayer of urgency, and a prayer of constancy. Today at this Eucharist, we remember those people whom we know from our life experiences, those who are partially impaired or fully blind. We ask the Lord to reach out to them, to touch and heal them, to give them the strength to in their day-to-day lives. We also pray for our own spiritual blindness. Spiritual blindness at times makes us incapable of seeing and appreciating the living presence of God in ourselves and in others. Amen.
Disciples, saying, "Take this,
all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald Gracious, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever.
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
take away the sin of the world, and have mercy on us. Lamb of God.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus,
I believe
that you are present,
in the most holy sacrament.
I love you
above all things,
and I desire
to receive you
into my soul.
Since I cannot at this moment
receive you sacramentally,
come at least spiritually
into my heart.
I embrace you
as if you were already there,
and unite myself
wholly to you.
Never permit me
to be separated from you.
Amen.
Pray for us.